you learned about the nutrition guidelines provided by the Choose My Plate diagram. Following the Choose My Plate guidelines will help you to make good food choices and eat a balanced diet. Eating a balanced diet with a variety of foods is important because no one food type contains all the macro and micronutrients that your body needs for good health. Recall from the last lesson that macronutrients include water, carbohydrates, fats, and proteins, while micronutrients include vitamins and minerals. It can be tricky figuring out which foods have each type of nutrient and how much of each nutrient they contain. For this reason, the U.S. government requires food labels to be printed on the packaging of many food products. This lesson will focus on helping you to read and understand food labels and the nutrition facts listed there. Here is an image of a typical food label. It's fairly easy to compare one food label to another, since the same information is given on each label. At the top of the label, you see the serving size. This tells you the amount of the food on which the rest of the nutrition facts are based. Pay careful attention to the serving size and also to the number of servings per container. Oftentimes, we eat more than the serving size listed, and sometimes what we might think of as being a single serving package might actually be labeled as containing two servings or more. For example, a typical can of soup contains 2 1-cup servings of soup per can. If you eat the entire can of soup, then you are eating 2 servings of soup, and you would have to double the amount of calories and all of the daily values listed on the label to accurately calculate your intake of nutrients. It can be very confusing, so pay close attention to this part of the food label. When comparing foods, for instance, if you are comparing 2 different kinds of soup, make sure the serving sizes are the same so you can make an accurate comparison. Below the serving size and the number of servings per container is the number of calories per serving. A calorie is a unit of measure for energy. So basically, this number tells you how much energy is contained in a serving of the food. Next to that item is the number of calories from fat. Generally speaking, no more than 30% of the calories you consume in a day should come from fat. It's better to satisfy your calorie needs with low-fat foods, so when examining food labels, look for lower numbers for this item in order to make healthier food choices. Below the calorie information is a list of all the macro and micronutrients contained in the food. For some of the nutrients, the amounts are listed in grams or milligrams. For most nutrients, the percent daily value is also listed. The percent daily value shows you how much of the recommended amounts of the nutrient is in a single serving of that food. For example, if the label states that the percent daily value for calcium is 20%, that means that by consuming 1 serving of this food, you will get 20% of the total amount of calcium you should be consuming per day. It's important to note that the percent daily values listed on a food label are based on a 2,000 calorie per day diet. Not everyone should be on a 2,000 calorie per day diet, however. Daily caloric requirements vary from person to person depending on their age, gender, activity level, and other factors. You can find out exactly how many calories you should be consuming on a daily basis if you use the Super Tracker tool on the Choose My Plate website. This interactive site asks a few simple questions and generates a personal food plan for you, complete with your caloric needs and suggestions for what types of food to eat. The fact that you might not be on a 2,000 calorie per day diet does not make the nutrition facts and percent daily values useless to you. These numbers can still help you to gauge your daily nutrient intake. Additionally, the percentages make it easy to compare one food with another, and they can give you a general idea of which foods are good sources of each nutrient. If you are trying to compare the nutrition facts for 2 different foods, make sure the serving sizes are the same in order to make an accurate comparison. Now that you understand the percent daily value, Let's take a look at each of the nutrients listed in the nutrition facts. The first nutrient listed in the label is fat. Fat is a macronutrient that is an important part of your diet. Too much fat in your diet can be problematic, but so can too little fat. There are a few different types of fat, and some of them are better for you than others. The two major groups of fats are saturated fats and unsaturated fats. Generally speaking, saturated fats are solid at room temperature and mostly come from animals. Unsaturated fats are oils that are liquid at room temperature and are usually plant-derived. Unsaturated fats can be monounsaturated or polyunsaturated. When choosing fats for your diet, polyunsaturated fats are the healthiest for your body, and monounsaturated fats are the second best. Saturated fats are the least healthy fat and should be limited in your diet. You might also see another type of fat listed on the food label, trans fat. Trans fat is another type of unsaturated fat that does not commonly occur in nature, but rather is industrially produced from vegetable fats. Trans fats have been associated with coronary heart disease, so it's best to limit this type of fat in your diet as well. Cholesterol is the next nutrient listed on the food label. Cholesterol is a waxy, fat-like substance that your body uses to make hormones, vitamin D, and is part of the structure of your cell membranes. Cholesterol is therefore necessary for body function, but your body actually makes all the cholesterol it needs, so you don't have to eat it, although cholesterol is found in some foods. Experts recommend eating less than 300 milligrams of cholesterol per day, regardless of your caloric needs. Under cholesterol is sodium. Sodium is an element that occurs naturally in most foods and most commonly in table salt or sodium chloride. Your body needs sodium to control blood pressure and for your nerves and muscles to work properly. Too much sodium, however, is not good for you and can lead to such health issues as high blood pressure, congestive heart failure, cirrhosis or hardening of the liver, and kidney disease. The recommended amount of sodium is less than 2,400 milligrams per day, regardless of caloric needs. Next on the list is carbohydrates. Like fat, carbohydrates are a macronutrient. Carbohydrates serve as your body's main source of energy and are found in breads, grains, pasta, potatoes, and other fruits and vegetables. Carbohydrates are divided into complex carbohydrates, or polysaccharides like starch and fiber, and simple sugars, which include monosaccharides and disaccharides. It's best to choose foods with complex carbohydrates over foods with simple sugars. Fiber is particularly important for digestive health, and it is recommended that an individual consumes 25 to 30 grams of fiber per day. The last macronutrient listed on a food label is protein. Protein can be found in meat, poultry, fish, eggs, nuts, and beans, and it is necessary for building muscle. When selecting proteins for your diet, it is best to choose lean cuts of meat that are not processed or high in sodium. Under the bolded line are all the micronutrients contained in the food, specifically the vitamins and minerals. Vitamins and minerals help to perform hundreds of jobs within the body, and it should be your goal to reach 100% intake for each vitamin and mineral every day. All food labels will contain information for vitamins A and C, and for the minerals calcium and iron. Some foods, like fortified cereals, for example, contain other vitamins, like vitamins B, D, K, or E, and other minerals like magnesium, potassium, or zinc. Not all food labels will list these other vitamins and minerals, however. If the food is not a significant source of vitamins and minerals, the food label will usually note that fact, or just omit them from the nutrition facts. Beneath the nutrition facts is a table that shows recommended amounts for certain nutrients for two caloric levels, a 2,000-calorie diet and a 2,500-calorie diet. As was already mentioned, your daily caloric needs might be higher or lower depending on your age, gender, and activity level, but these guidelines can be a helpful reference. Notice, however, that the recommended amounts of sodium and cholesterol do not change regardless of your caloric needs. For many people, nutrition can be a confusing subject. Hopefully, after completing this lesson, the topic will be a little more clear for you, and food labels won't be such a mystery. At this point, you should be familiar with the major nutrients that need to be in your diet. In the next lesson, we'll focus on a very specific nutrient, calcium.